Welcome to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim. I'm Amethyst Lunatari. Today I'll be reading Hagiographies of the Saints, which I found right here in the Cathedral of St. Martin. Hagiographies of the Saints of the Church of Cyrodiil by Brother Pistorius, First Pressing, First Seed, Fourth Era, 187. Printed under the authority of the Imperial Cult, Temple District, Imperial City, Cyrodiil. As well as the eight Aedra, the Imperial Cult recognizes the legitimacy of a number of saints, ancestors, and spirit gods. The following hagiographies deal with the 11 saints universally recognized as central to the state religion of the Imperial Cult of the Eight Divines. This text does not acknowledge local, tribal, or regional saints. Blessed be those who learn their names. Saint Alicia, the Paravania, Perif, and Al-Esh. Queen Ut-Sirad, Blessed Queen of Men, Liberator of Slaves from the Grasp of Aliad. Born in Sardavor Lead, she survived the Gut Gardens of Sursin. Touched by Akatosh, with visions of her champions at Sankrator, mortal and god, truth brought all together to take the White Gold Tower in First Era 243. Coveted by Akatosh, beloved of the first breath of man, championed by Penelil Elfscourge, she gave power to the man tribes and united the lands of Tamriel under the pantheon of Cyrodiil. Blessed be the name and everlasting blood of the slave queen, forever resting in the place of dragonfires where Dagon was banished. Morahous, first breath of the mother of men, the winged bull, breath of kine, the unassailable champion of the Lord's Male, demigod companion of Paravania known as Alicia, blessed with the Thuum and pure love of men. Consort to the Red Diamond Queen, Morahous carried Al-Esh high overhead during the liberation of the Vartash by the myth god champion Pelennil. Commander of the Slave Queen's armies, he led the tribes of man to secure the White Gold Tower from the Myrrh in First Era 243. Bullman, taker of the citadel, may yet walk among us, as he disappeared after the death of his love, Saint Alicia, in First Era 266. Powerful is the name and almighty strength of the Minotaur. Penelennil Whitestrake, the divine crusader, star-made knight and champion of the Slave Queen, also known as Penelennil Insurgent, the Bloody, the Blamer, and the Third. Glorious his deeds, mighty slayer of the Aeliad sorcerer kings in their great numbers, the liberator of men, avatar of Shazar, and blessed by the Eight. His bloodlust legendary as the many-named king and conqueror of the Morethic era, he pledged mace and sword to Saint Alicia. He defeated Umarel the Unfeathered to secure the White Gold Tower and commune with Morahous after being torn to eighths. Loved by all men and gods, patron of the Knights of the Nine. Mighty is the name and glorious the deeds of the star-made crusader. Roman I Cyrodiil, worldly god of men and emperor of sundered Cyrodiil united, his coming predicted by the Whitestrake. Found as an infant upon the golden hill of Hral Meet Alicia, Sankrator, with the Chimel Adabal upon his brow, he who is Cyrodiil come. The redeemer of the Akaviri hosts following their defeat at Pal Pass, revered as the first dragonborn emperor, Reman I united the many petty kingdoms of Cyrod and its environs. Patron of Reman dynasty, he restored the amulet of kings and ritualized the lighting of the dragonfires. Glorious is the name and the unifying force of the emperor. Martin Septim, priest of Akatosh and saint emperor of Tamriel, savior of Nern, from the hordes of oblivion, and blessed by all gods. Once lost son of Emperor Uriel Septim VII, found by the hero of Kavach in Cyrodiil's hour of need. He served as protector to people through the fall of Kavach, led the combined armies of the Empire against the Daedric menace during the defense of Bruma, and shattered the amulet of kings to give his life and mantle Akatosh. Sealer of the barriers between Nern and Oblivion, last and greatest of the Septim line, his avatar still stands in the Imperial City. Forever magnificent is the name and the ultimate sacrifice of the Savior. Maruk the Seer, monkey prophet of Alicia and designer of eminently practical laws, hallowed by Julianos and Saint Alicia. Imgut native of the once jungled shores of the Gold Coast, Baruch was blessed by the visions through afflictions of St. Alicia under the stars of the tower. She seared upon his mind the 77 inflexible doctrines, the basis of Cyrodiil's modern legal system. He would found the Brothers of Maruk, later the Elysian Order, that once great political and religious institution that would be poisoned by foreign gods. Creator of the civilized and reasonable credo, all are guilty until they have proven themselves innocent. Honor to the name and the eternal wisdom of the seer. Kulakane, Zero Emperor of the Seat of Sundered Kings and Mentor to St. Talos. King of the Creeth and the Kolovian Estates during the Interregnum, he tutored the mighty Emperor Tiber Septim in the ways of war and paved the way for his ascension as St. Talos. Architect of the Empire and liberator of three realms of men from the Bandit Kings, slain by Breton Nightblades upon the recapture of the Imperial City in the Night of Knives. He was revered in his passing by the Third Empire through the cult of the Emperor Zero. Wonder at the name and the continuing achievements of the ruler. Bender Olo, King Saint of Greater Kolovia, and Anvil in particular, vanquisher of the Sloed and hero of the All Flags Navy, patron of mariners and diplomats, favored by Stendar and honored by Cerebane. Sank the coral reefs of the Slugmen in the waters of the Sea of Pearls, saving Tamriel from the horrors of the Thracian Plague. Glory to the name and the mighty fleets of the sailor. Relav the Righteous, King Hero of Skingrad and Greater Kolovia, conqueror of tyranny and champion of the just. Ascended to his throne following plague and strife, Relav protected the West from the forces of the unjust Emperor Gorius and his misguided minions through skill and ingenuity, as well as horse and bird. Kissed by Kinnereth and blessed with wit, Relav continues to provide hope to all those who labor under oppression. Thanks to the name and the long-lived freedom of the Falcon. Kaladas the Builder, Master Mason of Xenothar and friend of Kinnereth, blessed with visions of the mace of the Divine Crusader centuries after Whitestrake's fall, he raised the champion in Leowyn in a single day with the Hand of the Eight. Constructor of many of the greatest monuments to grace Cyrodiil, blessed are his creations for standing Akatosh's time for 4 millennia. The pilgrims and master artisans who prayed before him were once rewarded with his sight, and many pray for his inspiration. Praise to the name and the enduring edifices of the Mason. Arendelle, Saint of Arkay, twice blessed by Dibella and inspiration of Stendar, bane of the undead and friend of the poor, martyred upon the stones of the Temple of Chadenhall, defending his flock against the Daedric Aeliad Umaril Hegemon. His reliquaries continued to protect the poor from the forces of the island that flies. Hallowed be the name and the everlasting shield of the ascetic. Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Beyond Skyrim, Hagiographies of the Saints.